only thing in this drawer was this bottle.
Could it be dragon sweat?
Spidery old-fashioned writing, hard to decipher. Dragon sweat. Dragon sweat! What is the probability of the headmaster having the one ingredient for magic ink in his drawer that I couldn't find anywhere else?
I don't
know. Talk about luck. I was expecting to find something here that would interest Remy. Instead, no bomb, no plan of attack, nothing. The headmaster seems to be the most law-abiding man in Seastone. Could he really be a danger to the Archmage? I'm pretty sure there's a law that prohibits murdering the Archmage. Why is he acting so strange? If he's not part of the plot against the Archmage, then who is?
The imposter that looks just like him. We can make this now. Sorry, we're running... Oh, leave the school? No. We're running a little late, I know, but... We have the last ingredient.
It's a tad weird that the headmaster has the most difficult to find ingredient for magic ink in his desk drawer. Was it this bottle he was putting into the drawer when I came in? Maybe it's the only bottle of dragon sweat in town and he didn't want me to get it. Or maybe he wants to build his own golem.
Or maybe he figured out that we'd want to build our own golem and this really is not dragon sweat but something else that would make the golem attack us or something like that. Or make the golem attack the headmaster. I'm not the headmaster, the archmage. 12 teen drops.
Well, I'll add exactly 12 teen drops of dragon sweat to the pot. And done. Alright, that's all of the ingredients in the pot. Now to give it a little stir. Ta-da! Magic ink. Small pot of magic ink.
I can't stand it, guys. We're gonna make the golem now. I know we're running late. Hold on. I really want to just accomplish this. Dip the quill in.
Right then. What do I need to write on the piece of paper to bring the golem to life? Just live?
Live!
Yes, in principle, but in golem language, and that's complicated, I'll dictate it to you. Grolop Grishna Kelabeb.
Wait a minute. Grolop Grishna Kelabeb? Those were a lot of words for a simple live.
Bringing dead material to life requires precise instructions.
Sounds logical. So what now?
Put the piece of paper in the golem's mouth. The rest happens automatically. But not before. Bringing half-finished golems to life is strongly discouraged.
Is he half-finished? Well, there's nothing else.
Live is written on the note in the complicated language of the golems. I just have to put the note in my golem's mouth. That should then bring it to life.
Hope he's not half finished.
Here we go. Blout, it's time. Do you want to watch?
Time for what? What are you two up to?
Willibur build golem.
Impossible.
Come, you allowed not to.
Right then. Live!
What
the hell
are you doing?
I felt it'd be boring without some thunder and lightning and so on. Bosh!
It's alive!
It's alive! Fantastic!
Willibur done it!
Right!
A real golem?
Help in inn. We have holidays.
But first, remember, he's going to be the Archmage's bodyguard until the election. It's just too bad he can't speak.
Hmm.
Unless, ooh, wait a minute. Can you write?
With those arms?
What are your orders, master?
Put paper
Let's
in mouth.
Go to the mage school. We can discuss everything else there.
Good work, Wilbur.
Thank you. It feels good to be able to take at least one worry off the Archmage's back. Until then.
Okay. Well, that's settled. We're past the 40-minute mark, so...
Mwah-ha-ha.
What?
Mwah-ha-ha-ha-ha.
That's not good. I knew it was planted. So yeah, I'm going to continue for a little bit more, and you're watching a part 2 of 2, I suppose. Oops. Hey! Who's that?
What's going on?
Kinda worried about the pause there for a second.
You looking for this? What the?
You looking here? Someone with a polyjuice potion. Who are you?
Oh, the Archmage spoke of an evil presence in the school. But I never thought that I was the presence. I was under your nose the whole time and you didn't even notice. Are you something like my evil self? I'm no petty sideshow conjurer. I'm the greatest sorcerer in the world.
What's his name? Yeah. Toadface? Munkus.
Munkus?
The one and only son of Archwitch Mortroga.
Tentacle thing.
Shapeshifter and evil genius.
I didn't know it was a shapeshifter.
Whose big, fat, hairy, green butt we kicked last time?
Yep, we'll do it again.
Not this time.
Oh, yeah, we will.
The alliance will break, and the kingdom of shadows will rise again with me as its leader.
How did I get up here?
What did you do to my golem? He was supposed to clean the school.
Well, it appears that your golem obeyed his true master's orders.
But it's supposed to defend the Archmage. Why doesn't the pisspot do something?
He can't. I fear that the spell which the slate provided, well, it contained more than just the order to live.
Oh, the slate's corrupted.
The slate was from you.
Ah! Lightbulb moment! Just like the dragon's sweat, the only ingredient for the magic ink that you were not able to find. We encountered each other when I put the sweat into the desk drawer. Remember?
So why didn't he just make his own golem? What are you planning to do, you monster?
You're a monster! So what are your plans?
Oh, so this is the part where the bad guy tells the hero his plan so he can scupper it at the last moment.
More or less.
Not this time. Nothing is going to stop me killing the Archmage.
That's your
you
plan.
You want to kill Alistair? You don't stand a chance. He's become more powerful than you can possibly imagine.
I admit, his magical powers are impressive. And he can sense my presence. As soon as I get within a few meters of him, he recognizes my evil intentions.
Okay, plant,
but
attack.
Oh.
That's right. Not magical powers, young friend. Good old physical strength will be his end. One hit from a machine that is neither good nor evil. He won't even know what hit him. You, go on ahead. I'll follow soon.
The head looks nothing like what we wanted. Release me, Monkus. Now.
I'm a teacher and a graduate mage. I demand that you release me immediately.
Otherwise, what?
I'll be very put off. Otherwise, I'm going to scream really loudly for help.
I'll scream really loud for help, or hold my breath until he let me down, or both at the same time.
The walls of this school are thick, and the Archmage should be in the staff room by now.
Then I'll just free myself and stop you.
Oh, how will you do that? Without this?
My
That's
wand?
That's mine! Give it back!
Just as delicate as peace in a world without the Archmage.
Oh, there it is. You can't break it. Can I, phooey, that was embarrassing.
Do you want to pretend that never happened? I mean, that was pretty embarrassing, right? The way you wanted to break that little thin wand and weren't able to. Remember? That one over there, you know? That skinny little wand on the floor, the really thin one that you couldn't break. That one. Nice one, Muscles.
Lols. You implemented your plan right under our very noses?
I have to admit, I'm a little impressed. How did you fool us like that?
Well, it wasn't easy. It took a master of intrigue to manage it.
Master of intrigue?
Perhaps true. You were in my first class too, right?
The boy, the headmaster, I was both of them. I was looking for a way to get at the Archmage.
Impressive. Maybe you could free me and tell me more about it.
You're right.
You're such a transparent liar, Weathervane. It's shocking.
I'll never let you harm the Archmage.
I'll stop you. You're not going to do anything to Master Alistair.
Oh, really?
Really?
Master Wilbur Weathervane, the big hero, will prevent it.
Yes, you will.
The very same Master Weathervane who built me the weapon I need?
No!
What will the people say when it's your golem who crushes the Archmage?
They'll say, holy crap.
And that's not all.
No!
That's not good. Okay, so we can look at the skeleton.
The curtain in my room is slowly disintegrating. Actually, someone needs to clean the classroom from bottom up. And by someone, I do not, however, mean me.
That's the first thing I'd be thinking about if I was hanging from a frickin' chain and someone's gonna kill the headmaster.
The curtain in my... And by someone, I...
Powerful magic wand. I can't... What?
Some mages can perform magic without a wand. That would be really useful about now.
Did you see that?
The wand would fly into my hand, I would cut my bonds, and no ice monster or anything else could hurt me.
Ice monster.
Nothing.
I thought I was going to fall out again.
I think that's the key to the shackles. It was given to me along with the other keys when I accepted the teaching job. Just a little...
Yeah, it's a little bit further, like 8 feet or something.
We're optimists by nature when it comes to physical characteristics. But I'm afraid the key is still out of my reach.
Hey, hey!
Timmy!
Timmy. Timmy?
What are you doing, Mr. Professor? Long story. You got to get me out of here, okay? Fast!
I thought I was going to get a chance to look at all these things.
Okay, what do you want me to do?
Okay, I do get to look at all these things.
I really hope that it wasn't a student. And I hope I don't end up like that.
Swing on over. No? Okay, I guess that won't work.
We can do it, right?
Of course.
Just do exactly what I tell you.
Will do.
We can do it, right?
Of course.
Okay, Timmy, take
can
the magic
you toss
wand.
The wand up to me, Timmy. Looks heavy. Try. Oh well. Good try, Timmy. The wand is too heavy for him. He can't throw it high enough.
I noticed.
The key on the desk, Timmy. Can you reach it?
I can't get up there.
I thought you were really good at climbing.
Yes, but not flying.
Well, think of something. Somehow we need to get Timmy onto the desk.
Do we still have all our stuff? No. I don't know why. I always want to wear the paper hat.
Timmy, a thread from the curtain. Can you bite one off?
I see we're the brains of this operation.
Well done!
Not that that's saying much.
Just do exactly what I tell you.
Will do.
Somehow we need to get Timmy onto the desk. Hey, it makes much more sense when you look at it this way. No, it doesn't. The wand is too heavy for him.
There's the wand, there's the desk. Well, what? Am I supposed to just keep swinging or something? Try again. Oh, it's different words. Different prompt. Sorry, my frames per second are getting low here. Sorry, guys. So what's this try again and all this stuff? Am I supposed to click it before he's done? Well, what we got?
Get any closer to it, but I got the skull and a little bone that was hanging off it.
Not so. I see the skull right there.
This isn't a human skull. It's too small and too heavy. I bet it's some kind of animal or magical creature that liked to bash its head against the wall. No wonder the the bone was hanging onto the skull. It's shaped like a hook. Hey, Timmy! I've got something for you. Catch!
So wind the thread around it. You didn't catch it.
Great! Now, please tie the hook to the end of the thread. Excellent! A grappling hook.
Now you can get on the desk to get something.
Can you use the grappling hook to climb onto the desk, Timmy?
Timmy? Hey, hey. Oh, that's right. The key's there.
Great! A wooden ruler. They used to be used not only to draw straight lines and measure out distances, but also as a substitute for a cane.
I guess if you're a gnome... Well,
all right! Grab the key!
It's gonna have to move the ruler first. No? Okay.
The ruler, Timmy! Can you push almost half of it over the edge of the desk? I've got an idea!
Are we gonna launch it, the key?
Perfect! About half of the ruler is on the desk, while the other half is hanging in thin air. Okay, Timmy, this is where it gets tricky. Please stand on the end of the ruler.
We're gonna launch you.
I know, the chances are one in a million, but we've got to try. Time is running out.
Well, if it doesn't work, it's probably dead Timmy.
Ready? Go!
How slow he climbed onto it. It was cute.
Way! Well, yay. How good was that? The shackles, fast! I love it when a plant...
It's gonna hurt.
Ow! Well, I'm free.
But your face is smooshed.
Well done! Now listen to me. You run as fast as you can to your Uncle Remy and tell him that there's an attack planned on the Archmage. Got it?
An attack on Master Alistair.
Right.
That shapeshifter Monkus is behind it. And he has a golem. My golem.
We can do it. I'll get Uncle Remy.
All right.
Anything in my room that might help me? Nope, don't think so.
Oh, forget your wand.
Got it! Let's hope I can do something with it. My trusty wand, fame and glory await us in the staff room.
Mm-hmm. Alright, let's go. Oh, something flashed by there. It's a shield hand.
Stop.
Stoop.
Admission only by written invitation.
Invitation? The Archmage is in danger.
But the Archmage is in there and he's in mortal danger.
Yeah, right.
But...
Look, I'm sure he can look after himself.
You will let me in there, now, because this always works.
I don't have time to play games, Shield Hand. You're going to let me in there.
Hello? Such a tone of voice from oh-so-friendly little weather vane.
Now!
I don't think so. I think you should...
Ooh! Neat. Takes care of that. How'd I do that?
Oh, just in time.
Ah, Wilbur, good to see you.
Hello, Archmage. Good to see you too.
Watch out.
No! No! No!
Oh.
Stop!
Ah!
Enough! I should have known that you'd be there, Smunkus. This is the last time you hurt Aventasia. I'm going to have you imprisoned and...
Oh, boy.
Alistair!
Woo! Ta-da!
Seriously?
Danger! We have an intruder, Wilbur Weathervane.
What the?
You're too late, Shieldhand. The Archmage has been murdered by him.
But
was your daughter? And he's a frog,
he
not dead.
He has murdered the leader of the Alliance, which makes me the new leader. Arrest him, Shieldhand.
The daughter, the frog. I didn't say it.
Wilbur, this way. Quick, put this on.
Stop them!
But you can't control it, sir. Or ma'am.
Out of the way!
Whichever. You don't have the magic.
Archmage, we have to...
We can't do anything right now. We should first consolidate our position and gather information. What happened exactly?
Munkus is behind all this.
Munkus is behind all this. He tricked us all.
Munkus? The sorcerer?
Right.
He can use his amulet to transform himself. He assumed the role of the street urchin and the school headmaster, at least temporarily.
We never found him in the Tower of Evil. And how could we? He must have disguised himself as one of our own soldiers and come with us to Seastone.
The golem, it's never followed any of my orders.
The golem has never really listened to me. That damned magic slate whispered him his real commands. I built the weapon which tried to kill the Archmage.
If you want to blame someone, then start with me. I encourage you to build the thing. It was my duty to not just think of the good, but also the bad it could cause. And your wand, what was that all about? The Archmage is the most powerful mage I know, and I saw him being turned into a frog, just like that.
I don't know. It behaved strangely yesterday in class, too. But I never would have thought that it was so powerful that even a little girl... It was the wand, the whole time. It did all the magic, not me. It's so powerful that even a little girl... It's all my fault. I didn't recognize Munkus, and I didn't realize there was a dark force coming from my wand because...
Wilbur.
Because, in reality, I'm not a mage at all.
Aw, I'm gonna go sleep in a shoe. Well, this is a shocking turn of events. What the hell?
What's the situation?
Not good. Another two of us have been turned into hamsters.
Hamsters?
The town is a nightmare in pink. The resistance has collapsed and the lower town is more like a ghost town. The Van Buren girl is transforming everything that is in her mother's way. There's nothing we can do to stop it. How's our patient doing? Come on, Wilbur. You can't go on like this. You've been lying there for days. We need your help.
Go away?
Go away!
Come on! We have to get the wand back of Van Buren's daughter and find a way to destroy it. And none of us knows about magical wands. You're the only one who does.
I don't have a clue about magic. Is that true?
Well, I don't know a thing about magic.
Doesn't know that much.
I just waved a magic wand around and if all went well, I was able to light a fire. A little girl could transform entire cities with the same wand.
But you still know more about magic than we do. And then there's your legendary ingenuity.
Where did it get me? I killed the Archmage and plunged the world into chaos.
He's not dead.
The world is always in chaos. And Alistair might still be alive.
Why should she let Mr. Alistair live?
But why would Van Buren leave the Archmage alive?
Why not? She feels invincible and is keeping him as a trophy. Van Buren has turned the school hall into a headquarters because the Archmage's office in the Mage Tower is hiding from her. And all the rattles in the school have been blocked off, so we don't know what is going on in there.
My magic wand. Where did you get the darn thing from?
You gave me the wand back in the day. Where did you get it?
I'm on my way there now to look for clues as to how it can be destroyed. Will you come with me?
I can't. I'd just make things worse.
No, you wouldn't. And you've wallowed in self-pity for long enough.
You tell him.
Hey.
There's no place for layabouts or cowards in the Resistance.
That's not...
Yeah? It's not what, Wilbur?
You're right. I'll go back to the White Ridge Mountains.
Fine. Then go home and wait until the war comes to you. But my ring stays here.
Hey, don't!
If you want to know what's going on with the wand, find me at the entrance to the lower cage.
Look at that cloth thing. Look at the sewage pipe, the mine wagon. Oh, all kinds of stuff to look at here. All right, that'll be next episode. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time, and a bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.